According to the best unbiased science, is there a clear relation between consuming beef and heart disease, cancer, and diabetes?
Oh, absolutely. So no question, beef is associated with these diseases, and particularly we see, you know, saturated fat and heart disease, of course, and beef is a significant source of saturated fat. So we see a link there. We see a link with diabetes as well, but probably the biggest connection is with colorectal cancer. And so in fact, if that red meat is processed, so beef being processed, we actually have very convincing evidence that it is a group 1 human carcinogen. And a lot of people make the mistake thinking that because it's in the same group 1 carcinogens include smoking or tobacco, asbestos, alcohol. These are group 1 human carcinogens, and so is processed meat. But it doesn't mean that processed meat is as bad as smoking. And I think that's important for people to understand. What this does is it says the evidence against processed meat is convincing. It doesn't give us sort of the level of carcinogenicity in the, you know, comparing that to smoking. It doesn't do that. So we don't know if smoking's a 10 where, you know, processed meat would lie. We just know that we have convincing evidence that it is a human carcinogen, particularly where colorectal cancer is concerned. Now, with red meat that's unprocessed, we have probable evidence, which puts it in what we call a group 2A category. So it's not as strong evidence, but it's still fairly substantial evidence that it is a probable carcinogen.
Explain what the EPIC Oxford Health Study was and what its conclusions were, and was this an important study?
So EPIC Oxford was also a very important study. So this was a study that is from the UK, where we had about 65,000 health-conscious individuals who were being followed. They were actually recruited between 1993 and 1999 and have been being followed ever since. And so there are multiple papers on this particular cohort. And this cohort is interesting because I think it's not quite as healthy of a cohort as the Adventist Health Study 2, where the Adventist Health Study 2, they have a little higher intake of fruits and vegetables and whole grains, and they tend to make sure they get enough B12, and they're a little more conscious and more informed where diet is concerned than I think the folks in EPIC Oxford. But nonetheless, EPIC Oxford found that vegans have 40% fewer cataracts than similar health-conscious non-vegetarians. That vegetarians and vegans have less, less diabetes, less heart disease. They've had a number of different reports. One report, I think it was about 32% less. Their vegans had about 19% less cancer, and they've looked at diverticular disease, and I believe it was 72% less for vegans and 27% less for lacto-ovo vegetarians. They've looked at a number of diseases, and generally, not 100%, but generally, the vegetarians and vegans are at an advantage. So very important study, and it's still ongoing.
Is the phrase "eat everything in moderation" a good way for people to stay healthy?
I love this question. It's, you know, moderation is important in life. I think we need to be moderate. I love that the Okinawans are so moderate. They have this saying, "Hairy Hachi Boo," which means eat only till you're 80% full. Eat moderately. But in our society, moderation is tricky, because if everything you do in moderation is bad for you, it will still kill you. And that's the case for many North Americans. So the moderation message, you know, if you think about corporations who are selling whatever processed food they're making, and they're funding Nutrition Month, or they're funding, you know, the Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics Association's nutrition education or whoever they're funding, the medical association, whatever, they will not be happy with messages that tell people to eat fewer of their products. So that eat less message, they're not going to be willing to fund whatever it is that's going on. However, the moderation message, they'll be willing to fund. Eat everything in moderation. All foods can fit in a healthy diet. There are no good foods, no bad foods. It just all fits. And we need to be really cautious of that, because when 70% of us die of chronic diseases that are induced by overconsumption, and when 70% of the population is either overweight or obese, and it's rising, the moderation message we need to be very careful of. Because what it says to people is, oh, it's okay to eat your deep-fried pork rinds, just eat them in moderation. No problem, drink your Coke, just drink it in moderation. That's not what people in North America need to hear. They need to hear, eat less of this crap, you know, and eat more fruits and vegetables, eat more beans, eat more of the foods that will actually promote and sustain health. Eat more green leafy vegetables. That's what they need to hear. So I think moderation is, to me, be very cautious. Yes, do things in moderation, but don't do all of these bad things in moderation, because you'll just die a little more slowly than you would otherwise.
Why does Finland have so much more heart disease than Japan?
Well, that's starting to change, but it's very interesting. Finland has, when we look at, there was a study done that kind of vindicated saturated fat by Chowdhury in 2014. At least they claimed it vindicated saturated fat. I don't think it did at all. Because what it did was it compared people it compared people in Japan who were eating 5% saturated fat with people in Japan eating 6% saturated fat. It compared people in Finland eating 12% saturated fat with people in Finland eating 14% saturated fat. And what it found was, well, gosh, there wasn't that big of a difference in those Japanese that were eating that, you know, small. But if they would have compared the people from Japan with the people in Finland, bingo! The people in Finland, their rates of heart disease were through the roof, whereas the people in Japan didn't have much heart disease. And I think the big issue is people in Japan tend to eat fairly plant-based. Their diet is carbohydrate heavy. They tend to eat a lot of rice and a lot of vegetables, and they tend to not overeat. There's not a lot of dairy there, so there's not cheese and ice cream and all of these things as much as what you would find in a place like Finland, where they eat a lot of processed meat, a lot of dairy, and a lot of meat, period. So I think that's really the clue.